Hello! Today I will show you how to create a program for random drawing. Let's look what you can have by the end of this video. Its main function is to draw connected lines randomly. It can also draw multiple lines with one click. The program supports all built-in colors. You are also free to delete lines one by one or clear the entire workspace. The program also allows you to draw with random colors. You can choose different thickness according to your needs. Users are also able to change the background. A very useful feature here is setting transparent background for using the drawing over something else, for example, a video. Finally, the workspace extends and reduces automatically according to the window size. In this video, I will show you how to create it step by step. So let's develop it from scratch. Create a new WPF application. I will name it RANDRAW, which stands for random drawing. In your grid, create canvas, which is a good container for drawing due to using coordinates. You can set its height and width to fix its size. Right in canvas, you can start creating drawing elements. There are a lot of them, but I will use only lines. Lines are elements that start at one set of coordinates and go to the second one. Create a line. Set its starting x coordinate to 10. And starting y-coordinate to 20. x2 and y2 will be both 50. Set the color of the line in the stroke property. The line's thickness is defined by the property stroke thickness. Let's set it to 4. Let's create another line. I will change only Y1. You can also change the other two coordinates. However, another way to change its position is to change the left property of the canvas element. We can also make lines with gradients instead of solid colors. To do that, we need to modify stroke. I will set radial gradient brush. Don't forget that you cannot specify the same property twice. In your radial gradient brush, set its gradient stops. It will be red in the center but blue on both sides. The proportion depends on the offset. Finally, let's create a horizontal line. To make a horizontal line, you need to specify different x-coordinates, but identical y-coordinates. For example, let's take 60. Choose any stroke you like. Again, you can make a gradient, but I will stick to a solid brush. When you launch your program, you will notice that after you resize your window, there is some white space. Don't be confused. It is a result of using canvas with fixed height and width. You can find all the same stuff that you see here on Microsoft's guide pages. But all this is statics. Not what I want, not what you want. We need controls to affect the drawing. First of all, give a name to your grid which will be used soon. Secondly, define two rows in your grid. The first one should have auto height because that will be our controls panel. This way, the second row will occupy all the space left and our canvas will be there. For now, I will use a stack panel for controls. Make it horizontal. Right from the start, we plan to allow drawing multiple lines. Create a text box for that and give it a name. And you need a button to call drawing. You can leave it without a name. Now replace the size of canvas with the row property and set it to 1. Go to your button click event, create a new instance of a line and initialize it. In C#, you specify the stroke using a brush. The coordinates are set almost like in XAML. I will set the stroke thickness to 2. Finally, add a line. This time I will add it to the grid. If you run the program, you will see that a line is created dynamically.